Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, one day I saw this elderly couple. I saw that they were so loving. They sit next to the other very close. It looked like they had a second honeymoon. Then I asked, "Grandpa, why you sit so close with your wife? You are in advance in your age already. Why you are so romantic?" "Father, do you know why I sit close and very close one another? So that I can hear properly to my wife." So my dear friend, don't be close holding hand only on Orchard Road. "Father, I holding my wife in Orchard Road." "Why?" "So that she will not go for shopping." The feast of the Holy Family uphold the family of Jesus. They stay close one another. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph as a model of Christian families everywhere. The celebration of this feast is relatively new, first appearing in the liturgy at the end of the 19th century and officially adopted into the Roman Catholic Church calendar in 1921. Observed on the first Sunday after Christmas, this holiday reminds us of the important role that family play in Jesus and of its importance in the life of the church. When Catholic family broke into pieces, the church can also collapse. But when our Catholic family is strong, care and close one another, we build up. When a Catholic family is good, the society is good, the church can be flourishing. So my dear friend, celebrated within a week of the Feast of the Incarnation, God became man, God with us. The Holy Family emphasizes Jesus' humanity. Jesus experienced ups and downs as a boy in the Jew family. Sometimes I feel during the Christmas season, Jesus grown up too fast. See, only a few days already 12 years old. So I hope that Christmas season can be longer so that it is more natural. Jesus not only adopted a human body but also become familiar with the very ordinary challenges and struggles of family life. He is and he was truly became one of us. In addition to revealing Christ's humanity, this feast of Holy Family reminds the faithful of the important role that family plays in the Christian and Catholic life. Leaving us in a family as God intended, as the potential to make us more Christ-like. We look to Mary and Joseph and to their relationship with their son as a model of mutual love, respect, and trust essential to the Christian family. The gospel reading in the liturgy for this feast day cycle among three important events in the early life of Jesus' family: the flight into Egypt, the presentation of Jesus in the temple, and Mary and Joseph's discovery of Jesus in the temple, as we heard in today's Mass. That's why, my dear friend, family, remember, family stand for Father and Mother, I love you. Because we have the love of God. In Jesus, we call God our loving Father. And we have Mother, our spiritual Mother, Mother Mary. Mother Mary guide and console us in our family life. And then everyone in the family must take the role and contribute to be present, so that love, Jesus, can be present in you, in my family. But it is a pity sometimes family become Emily. We don't want letter F. We don't want God anymore. Then remain Emily. After marriage, I leave you. Because no God anymore. That's why God is very important in our family life. Put Jesus to be the center in our day-to-day life. When a family love Eucharist, the family love Jesus. This afternoon I had another wedding, and again the bride kept on crying. I told her after wedding day, the groom keep on crying because of you. If there is no wedding, please keep on crying. My dear friend, family base and center in Jesus, our family can be different. If to your family, my family, there is no such perfect family. We have our own shortcoming and weaknesses, but by putting Jesus to be the center in the family life, Jesus can unite us, can give us strength to forgive and to move on, to keep on loving our family members. Don't ever, my dear friend, leave Jesus in your family life. Put Jesus again and again by maintaining family prayer together, maintaining our daily Eucharist, Sunday Eucharist, to really put our life centered in Jesus. In this Holy Family celebration, let us ask the protection from Mary and Joseph. Their act of faith and obedience to God are a model of parental care, protecting, nurturing, and ultimately letting go. If you notice the news these days, not long ago in United States, the person killed so many children just like that. Recently in KK Hospital, the baby mixed up. So it seems our society not care and take care family, our children, seriously. So let us, as a Catholic family, again, we want to treasure our family. We want to show our respect, children, to the parent. When the parent getting older, father, I have money, I put my mom, my father in St. Joseph home, St. Teresa home, Orange Valley home, but I never visit. I just give money, I just give material thing, but I never show our love. Remember, when we honor our father, we honor our mother, we honor God, we honor Jesus. That's why for those who honor their parent, God will show them the happiness in their life. My mother now getting old. She is 85 or 86. So every day I try to say hello. How are you, mom, today? How is your blood pressure? Oh, today my blood pressure over 200. Wah, very dangerous. So you must eat something so that your blood pressure can come down. But that call, that care. So you know, do you know, when I hear your voice, I am very happy. So my dear friend, let us show our love and our care. And then my mother complained, now my eyes not so clear, I cannot see, I forget, cannot see properly. But how to see money? To see money very clear. Especially rupiah with so many zero. So my dear friend, let us once again treasure our family life, because in the family we experience love. We receive and we give love. The secret of a happy marriage, a successful family, when every member of the family think about the loved one, not think about himself or herself. So let us, in this Holy Family Sunday, we give thanks for the gift of our loved one, our parents, our sibling, even though they are not perfect, but God give them relatives. God give us family member to show his love and care. But we thank God that we can choose our friend. Friends can show us that God love us and care for us through their friendship. Amen.